Hello everyone, it's Kitty. As we are creeping into late October, preparing ourselves for the spookiest season of all, I believe it's about time I tell you some of the scariest elements of early star stable. We were once young, and these elements without a doubt sent shivers down our spines when encountered. The community has spoken and reached out to me to deliver some of these ghostly details about old star stable that left them terrified for days. As for whether these elements were intentional or not, remains unknown. But without a doubt, we can all agree that it gave the game so much character. And we look back on these memories with a smile. That is all that matters. For a moment, let me transport you back to the earlier days of Star Stable, back to the time when we were all just naive children, riding around on our silly little ponies. Allow me to reopen the scars that Star Stable left us with its eerie, mystical, and above all, unpredictable environment. Admittedly, we were all a bit mischievous back in the day, willing to bend the rules of Star Stable just to tame our curiosity. We never realized it would come back to bite us, though. The scenario I am describing is whenever you would intentionally, or unintentionally, wander into a restricted area. Unexpectedly, your screen slowly faded to black, displaying a very threatening message. You are in a closed area and you will be moved home. Repeated attempts to get into closed areas can lead to suspension from the game and possible banning. Once you are sent home, the message would take even longer to fade out, sending chills down every kid's spine. Suspension? Ban? This gave me a mental checkmark to never be foolish with closed areas ever again. Around 2018, Star Stable revisited this warning and deemed it as too menacing for the younger audience. My memory fails me on exactly how the message was constructed, but receiving it made me take it far less seriously than the original warning. Without a doubt, one of my favorite and most memorable storylines in Star Stable was Justin's abduction. A quest you complete very early into your Star Stable journey, after you depart Moreland after saving the stables from GED. You make your way into the heart of Yorvik, Silverglade. While you are there, you visit their equestrian center. As you are there, you are practically enlisted as their stable girl. Amidst your chores, you find yourself wrapped up in a whole lot of family drama, secrets spanning decades. A lot more is going on behind the scenes than you can ever imagine. You come to find out about the Dark Riders and Mr. Sands, and question what they want with Justin. The problem is, you are not the first person to uncover these secrets. Linda, once an assistant to the Baroness, found out about the Baroness's entanglement with Mr. Sands. Out of fear, Linda was requested to be met by the butler behind the stables at night, leading to her being kidnapped and locked in the Silverglade Castle for days. If you happen to ride past the castle at night, you could hear Linda crying. This whole storyline is incredibly dark for a children's game, but ultimately led thousands of players to become invested more than ever in the plot and the world of Jorvik. This detail sent shivers down my spine the first time I had noticed it, and admittedly, still does. Secret areas are one of the many charming elements of the game. Places that are not marked on a map and make you feel like a pro player for knowing. Allow me to share the first ever secret area I discovered that gave me chills the first time I had found it. This place took me about an hour to finally locate, but it did not disappoint when I finally did. I genuinely thought my friends were joking when they told me that they had discovered a UFO in Jorvik. But they were not kidding. Once I found the spaceship and the suspenseful music started to roll in, I was shocked and confused. I could not believe what I had stumbled upon. This discovery led me to question what this extraterrestrial shuttle was doing here. Why did it crash? Who was on the UFO? Did they survive? Were there any casualties? Many theories arised, but to be honest, it had kept me awake for many nights. The UFO crash site was a very unexpected and terrifying place to discover. What's even more terrifying? That the truth about its place here on Jorvik has yet to be uncovered. Honestly, we've come to realize that Star Stable can become a very different game at night. So many unpredictable and strange things can happen to you, especially if you are a newcomer. Tell me, have you ever allowed time to escape you? Have you ever found yourself cuddled up with your favorite blanket at night, accompanied by your laptop, experiencing your favorite places in Star Stable, only with a nightly twist? It was all fun and games, until you are unexpectedly greeted with a message you have never seen before. Dusk is coming. The night is closing in. For a majority of players, this message is very frightening and prone to causing jump scares, especially if you are young and mischievously staying up past your curfew. Reading this message made me think I was in trouble. Some perceived this message as threatening, as if something was coming to get them. Who knows? Maybe it did. The game Star Stable Online was created on a foundation of realism. There are, of course, fantasy elements within the story that you come to discover the farther you participate in quests. Due to popular belief, the game has strayed away from its original logic, with the inclusion of unicorns and magic horses. But for the most part, the game is still pretty realistic. For example, when you fall off a cliff, you do not fly. Instead, you are placed back to where you were before your fall, with a warning along with a horrific sound effect symbolizing your horse's demise. You have taken a dangerous fall, but miraculously, you got back up. Try being more careful in the future. This warning, alongside the red screen and sound effect of my horse neighing in pain, completely freaked me out as a kid. I got used to it after a while, but it taught me to become more cautious, as it did once affect my horse's health. Did you know that, according to the Star Stable lore, Golden Hills Valley is actually a very dangerous place? When you begin the journey to unlock this area, it is revealed by the councilmen of Silverglade and Conrad Marsden that Golden Hills Valley is kept locked during the winter to keep evil spirits from escaping the valley and terrorizing the children and horses of Silverglade. you begin to realize what they said was completely true. As shortly after you unlock Golden Hills Valley with a copy of the key, you are met with vicious wolves who protect the territory of Shadow Hills, the road leading to Pie the Witch's Swamp. When you attempt to encounter these wolves by riding into their territory, your screen fades to black with a warning. That is not all. Later in the story, when you must retrieve the golden apple from Scarecrow Hill to heal Pie, you are attacked by scarecrows that have come to life. When you approach the scarecrows, your screen fades to black, and you are given a warning, much like with the wolves. Both of these encounters terrified me when I had first started these quest lines. I felt horrified when I received these warnings that were followed by terrifying music and sound effects. The Hollow Woods will be receiving an update pretty soon, so it is more than appropriate to discuss this next haunting detail. The abandoned summer house. This summer house was originally owned by the Silverglade Councilman's predecessor, and had fallen victim to a mysterious fire. The original owner had kept copies of town records and other various documents held within the house. Seeing the summer house lie there on top of the hill, burnt and run down, made me wonder how it happened to catch fire, and if the people living within the house made it out alive. Many players started to notice strange, unidentifiable noises come from the abandoned summer house at night. Very unsettling. Shortly after the release of Mistfall, the long-awaited expansion of Firgrove, players took to exploring the amazing scenery and nature that this area had to offer. Their only mistake was exploring at night. They claimed to have heard the most blood-curdling screams in the forest, although it is hard to decipher. Due to the overwhelming mask of crickets chirping, rivers flowing, and owls hooting. The players came to the conclusion that it was just the sound of an elk bugling. Until 2 years later, Star Stable revealed a terrifying urban legend about a Yorvik ranger gone mad. She had been locked inside a fire-spotting tower, wailing for help. When the rest of the Rangers had arrived at the scene, it was already too late. To this day, she haunts the tower at night. Her screams can still be heard throughout Mistfall. There's one part about this legend that still doesn't sit well with most. The door to the tower was locked from the inside. So, what do you believe? Is it an elk or a misfortunate soul? In Jorvik, there are many suspicious forces at play. They can appear even when you least expect it. In May of 2013, the wizard Idris arrived in Jorvik with the dream of running his own circus tent in the Highlands. He requested for our help, and then we began the preparations for the circus. We even reached out to other citizens of Jorvik to help aid us in our journey of building the circus tent. Once we added the finishing touches, the circus was officially open to the public, which meant we could explore inside of the tent and even perform routines on our horse. Although, you couldn't help but notice like you were constantly being watched every step you take. It wouldn't be a circus show without an audience. Though, the spectators may be anything but ordinary. Their gaze was constantly fixed on you. There was never applause, never a sound to be made from this crowd. They wouldn't even unveil their face, but the radiant glow from their eyes was apparent. You cannot help the shivers being sent down your spine when their focus is on you. Star Stable's storyline is irresistibly immersive, especially in the very beginning of your journey here on Jorvik. I had mentioned how alluring the Justin's disappearance and freeing Linda chapter was. After all of that had played out, we became more familiar with the secret forces at play on the island. It turns out, we play a bigger role in saving Jorvik than we imagined. The Keepers of Aiden constructed a plan for us to finally confront Justin. This mission was do or die. In order for us to go undercover and sneak into Darkcore, we had to trick some goons into delivering our horse instead of Justin's horse to the headquarters, while we hide in a fridge on the barge for hours until we finally arrive at our destination. The stakes were high. You could not resist the adrenaline coursing through your veins. It was unfamiliar territory with an unfamiliar objective. No matter what you do, do not get caught. If you were caught, your screen would fade to black, accompanied by a horrifying sound effect of one of the goons. It was hard not to mess up. It was dark in the headquarters, the objective was unclear, and tensions were high. Undeniably, it was hard not to feel nervous and scared during this mission. Well, that is all the ghostly gossip I have for you today, my spiderlings. Tune in next week, and there may be another story waiting for you. Reminiscing with you all, as always, has been a pleasure. The scary and somewhat disturbing elements of Star Stable Online are what got me interested in the first place. On the outside, Star Stable is nothing but a mere family-friendly horse game for children. By including the plotline of a rich socialite imprisoning her assistant in her family's castle just because the assistant found out generational secrets, fueled my desire to come back every day to learn more about what the story of Star Stable has to offer. Or maybe the inclusion of possible paranormal activity occurring in Jorvik that has yet to be discovered, it leaves a lot of room for more stories to be told. I hope in the future, Star Stable can tap back into that eerie and mystical edge that it once had. Judging by my history alone, it worked wonders for my investment. That's all I have to say. I encourage you to write to me in the comments all about your opinions, what frightened you the most, and even your own memories. I get my greatest ideas from you. I upload videos regarding the history of Star Stable and overall nostalgia. If that sounds desirable to you, consider subscribing. If you're dying for more nostalgia, my Instagram is the destination for you. My handle is kittispiderweb on Instagram. When I reach 3,000 subscribers, I believe it is time you all knew the face behind these documentaries. Until next time, this has been Kitty Spiderweb, signing out.